Hello everyone, I am Dr. Muhammad Ismail, Department of Zoology, JT College, Malegaon. In this video, we are going to see epimers and enomers. Actually, it is the third part of video. In the first video, we have learnt about isomers, its type in carbohydrates. And in the second video, we have gone through stereoisomerism, optical isomers as well as geometrical isomers. And now in this video, we are going to see epimers and enomers. So let's start isomerism. Now the next concept is epimer. What are the epimers? Epimers are a specific kind of geometric isomers that have multiple or more than one stereo centers or stereogenic center, means a carbon atom that has four different atoms or groups of atoms bonded to it. Stereogenic center or stereo centers are the carbon atom that has four different atoms or groups of atoms bonded to it, but only differ from one another by the configuration at one of the stereogenic center. Epimers are a specific kind of geometrical or geometric isomer that have multiple stereogenic or stereo centers, but only differ from one another by the configuration at one of the stereogenic center. So that condition present in the epimers, and these are known as epimers. If two monosaccharides differ from each other in their configuration around a single specific carbon atom, means other than anomeric carbon atom, they are referred to as epimers to each other. If two monosaccharides differ from each other in their configuration around a single specific carbon other than anomeric carbon atom, they are referred to as epimers to each other. For example, glucose and galactose are epimers with regard to carbon number 4, means they are known as C4 epimers. That is, they differ in arrangement of hydroxyl group at carbon number 4. Similarly, glucose and mannose are epimers with regard to carbon number 2, and that's why they are known as C2 epimers. Now, look at this figure. In this figure, centrally placed linear structure of glucose is there, which is having chemical formula C6H12O6, and left and right side of glucose molecules are its epimers. The left side compound is the mannose, is differing only at carbon number 2 from glucose. That's why it is C2 epimer of glucose. Similarly, the right side compound is the galactose and is differing only at carbon number 4 from glucose. So it is C4 epimer of glucose. The remaining atom of carbon backbones or carbon backbone are same, but they are different from each other only at a single stereogenic center. So this condition is known as epimers, and these compounds are known as epimers. Okay. The next concept of this video is enomers. Now, what is enomers? Enomers are special type of epimers. An enomer differs at a new asymmetric carbon atom when a ring is formed. When a ring is formed, means the conversion of linear carbohydrates when converted into cyclic form, and in the cyclic form, new asymmetric carbon atom is considered as a anomeric carbon atom for formation of anomers. In cyclic form, in cyclic form of carbohydrate, carbon number 1 is called as anomeric carbon atom. Carbon number 1 is known as anomeric carbon atom. The orientation of hydrogen and hydroxyl groups around this anomeric carbon atom will give rise to two isomers, and these isomers are known as anomers. In one form, the hydroxyl group is above the anomeric carbon atom. They are known as beta form or beta anomer. And if the hydroxyl group is downward, then it is called as alpha form or alpha anomer. In cyclic form of sugar, the anomeric carbon atom is the carbon atom that was part of carbonyl group in the straight chain structure. Now look at this figure. When linear form is converted into cyclic form, the carbonyl carbon or carbon carbon atom is known as anomeric carbon atom, means carbon number 1. In this structure, the left side is alpha D glucose, and in this the hydroxyl group is present below the anomeric carbon atom, while in beta D glucose the hydroxyl group is present above the anomeric carbon atom. Look at the position of hydroxyl group in both this structure. At carbon number 1, this carbon number 1 is known as anomeric carbon atom or anomeric carbon, and in this the hydroxyl group is present below the carbon number 1, then this condition is known as alpha D glucose. And if the hydroxyl group is present above the anomeric carbon, means carbon number 1, then this condition is known as, or this form is known as, beta form or beta glucose. Similarly, in fructose, one more thing, carbon number 1 is the anomeric carbon atom in glucose. Similarly, in fructose, alpha and beta anomers are present, but fructose is a keto sugar. The anomeric carbon atom is not the first carbon atom, but carbon number 2 is the anomeric carbon atom in keto sugar. Point to be remembered that in aldoses, means glucose, galactose, all these thick sugar, in aldoses the anomeric carbon atom is carbon number 1, while in ketoses the anomeric carbon atom is carbon number 2. In this figure, the left side figure is the linear form of fructose. When it is converted into cyclic form, the hydroxyl group at carbon number 2 is present below the carbon atom, then this isomer is known as alpha D fructose or alpha anomer of fructose. In the last figure, in the third figure, the hydroxyl group is present above the carbon number 2, which is the anomeric carbon atom in keto sugar, and fructose is the keto sugar. Then the anomer is known as beta D fructose. Now, anomers have different physical properties due to their differently arrangement of atoms in a space. different melting point is there and their specific rotation is different one. So these are the different properties of anomers. Okay, I hope the video is informative for you. Thank you. Thank you so much.